Hi everyone, Molly here. Welcome to your practice. So there come times in life where it just feels like there's so much to digest. And if you did the Earth Day practice with me a few weeks ago, we talked a little bit about this idea of digestion. But in moments like this, it's a really important one to consider. Especially as we seem to be taking in a lot of information, we're being pushed to consider things in a lot of new ways, which is wonderful for our evolution, for our growth, but sometimes it definitely feels like overeating, like we start to feel a little stuck, a little like we want to draw into our turtle shell because we're not exactly sure how to digest all of the information that's coming our way. And in fact, even in our lingo, at least in the English language, and I would imagine in many different languages, we even have a metaphor for this idea of digesting something, right, that goes beyond just the nourishment, the food that we eat. When someone gives you something to consider that you don't necessarily like straight away connect with, or maybe you don't understand, what do we say? We say, you know, I'm going to chew on it for a little while, right? So this recognition that we have to digest everything that comes our way. And the beautiful thing about being in this physical world, and especially being in this physical body, is if you think about it, the very foundation of your physical body is in fact movement and flow. And we talk about this a lot in yoga, right? Finding our flow. But your blood flows, your breath flows, your lymph flows. And when all of these things are flowing, then the rest of the functions of the body flow in reflection of how these other entities are flowing. And so just moving and breathing actually helps us to digest the whole of life, even without having to necessarily consider the philosophical ideas or understanding what's underneath it at the spiritual level. That actually naturally comes when we keep the foundation of ourselves moving. And so today's practice is dedicated to this idea of digestion again, just to help keep us on the path as a community, as a Sangha, and within our practice, remembering that when we begin here, when we begin at home in our bodies to keep flow, and today, of course, we're going to focus on the parts of the body that in traditional Chinese medicine and in the yogic philosophy are most closely associated with this idea of digestion, but to really help us build a foundation upon which we don't have to unbutton our pants because we've eaten too much, but we can actually keep the flow of digesting all that's coming to us in a more healthful way. And within that, just as a little side note, of course, is the choice to stop eating. At a certain point, right, we start to feel so full and so incapable of understanding all that's coming to us that maybe it's the moment where we step away or we go to the park and take a walk for an hour without our cell phones or with a good friend where we can talk and share ideas and digest in that way. So that piece of it as well, not just having to constantly keep up with life with this idea of digestion, but sometimes honoring that we understand that we've taken in so much that the only choice is to give ourselves a moment to digest all that's come to us. So if you haven't already, go ahead and clear your space so that you're free to move in whatever way. And additionally, as you're moving through the practice today, every suggestion that I give, you're digesting. And so please look after yourself and understand that every new thought you invite into your practice is something that also needs to be digested. So breath, body, movement, as we enter our practice together today, and be mindful to take care that this is your time, however you want to embrace it, however you want to digest it. Okay. We're going to start in child's pose today. So just find a place sort of in the center of your mat, touch your big toes together, and first just kneel back and make your knees really nice and wide, maybe entering this posture in a slightly different way. And then once you feel your hips as heavy toward your heels as you can, and this is a good place to slide a pillow or a bolster too if the hips are really high off the heels, just let your hands fall onto the mat first and relax your body. And then begin your descent by walking those hands forward any amount, beginning to stretch through the spine, but being mindful to keep the hips really nice and heavy. Here in the beginning, the arms can relax down toward the mat. The fingertips are soft. The face is soft. And so the parts of the body most highly associated with digestion, the abdomen, of course, but the hips, the meridians of digestion ascending along the anterior and interior part of the legs. And so folding and strengthening and twisting throughout our practice today to just help guide the body toward a more healthful digestion of all that's coming to us in these days. So here, as you begin to recognize that there's really nowhere to go and nothing specific to do in these next few moments, begin to connect with your breath. And as the body responds to the suggestion of this shape, maybe starting to feel the sides of the belly kind of melting between the thighs, the heart, also surrendering back toward the ground. And let the intimacy of this shape, this posture, the position of the child, give you a little more courage to take some deeper breaths. Gently inviting the inhale to become a little more full and the exhale a bit more complete. And always here at the beginning of our practice, a beautiful time to reconnect with the natural intelligence of the breath, the inhale, bringing in energy, but maybe for today's practice, with a gentle intention on digestion, the exhale, an opportunity to blow away the residue of all that we're digesting, all the bits and pieces that we don't really need to keep responsibility for or of. Some say it's a release of toxins, but I like to think of it more just the body's intelligence processes things, and that which we don't need to hang on to, that which we don't need to carry into our journey, we just breathe it away. Not necessarily toxic, just the natural byproduct of digestion. Good. And have three more big, deep breaths here. And maybe starting to feel how also this pause is so important. Do the work and step back to understand what it all is. Right. At the end of your next exhale, look between the hands and begin to glide forward to your hands and your knees, placing the knees under the hips and the wrists under the shoulders. Maybe extending that right leg back behind you, toes tucked under to get a little stretch of the calf and the ankle, a little rock back and forth here across the ball of the foot, and then switching sides. extending the left leg back behind you and a little rocking motion. Beautiful. And then bring that left knee in. Again, knees under the hips, a little cat and cow to start cultivating the movement of the body. Inhaling to lift the head and tailbone, softening the belly. Exhale, rounding through the spine, rocking toward the fingertips, spreading between the shoulder blades. Inhale, melt the heart, lift the bum and the top of the head up. Exhale, press into the palms, rock toward the fingertips, and round the spine a lot. Inhale, lift the head and tailbone, soften the belly. Exhale, round through the spine. Beautiful. Come back to a neutral spine. Touch those big toes together. Sit the hips back as we began, but spread your wings to either side. Touch the left fingertips down to the floor and reach that right arm up overhead for a big side stretch here. Do your best to keep your feet, your toes relaxed as you do. Come up through the center, touch the right fingertips, up and over you go with the left arm sweeping up and over the left ear. Gaze can stay straight ahead, maybe looking down toward the right hand, maybe even looking up. And come on back through the center, place your palms right in front of your knees, press down and forward, round the spine once again like cat, and tuck your chin really deeply toward the chest. A generous push down and forward into the mat with the hands to feel some spaciousness coming into the back of the body. And then glide those hands all the way back behind you. Fingertips press into the mat to invite the chest to begin to lift up. And then if it's okay for the neck, let the eyes lift toward the ceiling, just tossing the head back, but lifting through the chest a lot. Great, come on back to the center. Walk those hands forward to your hands and your knees once again. Inhale, cow, lift the head and tailbone, soften the belly. Exhale, cat, round through the spine. Beautiful. Come on back to a neutral spine. Take one step forward with your palms, widening the stance between the hands and the knees, making the movement a little bigger as you inhale, lifting the head, but dropping the hips gently forward. Exhale, reach the hips all the way back toward a child's pose, extending through the arms. Good. Inhale, glide forward, kind of like cow, lift the top of the head, drop the hips. Exhale, all the way back to child's pose, dancing with the breath here a few more times. Inhale, glide forward, a gentle bend of the elbows to start lifting the chest a little bit more. Exhale, glide all the way back. Inhale, glide forward. Great. Lift the center of the chest. Let the hips drop. Exhale, all the way back you go to your child's pose. Good. Inhale, glide forward. Bring the hands in just a little bit for steadiness. Touch your big toes and have a seat on the heels once again. Spread your wings like airplane wings or bird wings or eagle wings. Whatever kind of wings you want, touch those left fingertips down and sweep the right arm up and over. For a little added stretch through the side of the rib cage, just let the right hip fall to the right of the right heel. And come on back through the center, touch those right fingertips down, sweep the left arm all the way up and over, and again, sliding that left hip a little farther to the left if you wish. Come on back through the center, press the palms in front of the knees once again. A generous push down into the ground to round through the spine and tuck your chin. Maybe looking at your belly button and see if you can draw it in, squeeze it in a little tighter as you spread between the shoulder blades. Have a nice deep breath here. And then glide those fingertips back behind you. Once again, press into the mat behind your toes to lift the chest first. The lifting of the chest, the priority here, maybe a tossing back of the head. Maybe just looking forward and watching the center of the chest grow and lift. Beautiful. Walk those hands all the way forward to your hands and knees once again. Tuck the toes behind you. A gentle lift to your first downward facing dog. Keep the knees soft. Let the heels tumble toward the mat. Arms straight and strong as the hips float up to extend through the spine. Maybe a pedaling through the feet here, right and left and right and left. Inviting movement into each situation we find ourselves in to keep the fluidity of the body and thereby the fluidity of digestion. And then come on back to a neutral position. Soften your knees and walk your hands backwards to your feet, finding a wide-legged standing forward fold at the back of your mat. Allow the head and the neck to hang. Inhale, lift halfway here. Place the left hand under your face. Bend the left knee. And on your next inhale, reach that right arm high to the sky, beginning to twist through the center of the body here, stimulating our ability to digest. Good. Lower the right arm, replace the left hand with the right hand, bend the right knee and lift the left arm high to the sky. Keep reaching the top of the head gently forward to keep length through the spine. And then lower the left hand, soften the knees, relax the head, and on an inhale, roll to stand all the way up at the top. Reach those fingertips high for the sky. On your next exhale, right arm back, left arm forward, look to the right. Inhale back to the top. Exhale, right hand forward, left arm back, look toward the left thumb. Inhale, back to the top, palms come together above the head. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana, relax the head. Walk the hands forward to downward facing dog, just touch for a second, and continue to glide forward, high plank position. Bring the big toes a little closer together, Vashisthasana, right side plank. A little extra challenge today. Lift that left leg off the right and see if you can hold steady for a moment here. And then come through the center, high plank position, steady through the belly, getting strong and firm. And on the left outer edge of the left foot, left hand, Vashisthasana, left side. Again, maybe floating that right leg just a little off the left. Finding your steadiness, breathing to help the body digest the suggestions. Come on back to a high plank position, downward facing dog. One deep breath here as you feel the spine have natural, gentle traction. And then soften the knees, walk the hands backwards, Uttanasana, at the back of your mat. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Exhale, pause here. Inhale, left knee bends, right arm reaches up toward the sky, twisting through the center of the body. Exhale, touchdown. Inhale, right knee bends, left arm lifts. Exhale, touchdown, relax the head, soften the knees. Inhale, roll up one vertebrae at a time. All the way to stand, bring your arms with you, reach the fingertips high toward the sky. Exhale, right arm back, left arm forward, look toward the right thumb. Inhale, back to the center. Exhale, right arm forward, left arm back, look toward the left thumb. Great. Inhale, back to the center. Palms find each other overhead. Exhale, fold forward. Relax the head. Walk the hands forward once again. Touch downward facing dog and then continue to glide forward. High plank, steady as she goes. Vashisthasana, right side. Lift the left leg high to the sky and sweep the left arm overhead. A little playfulness here. Send that left leg a little forward and the left arm a little back behind you. And then switch that direction, bringing the left arm forward and the left leg back. Great. Come, sweep forward, arm back, leg forward. Leg back, arm forward. If you topple over and fall, that's great. Digest that information and try again. Come on back to a high plank position. Hold steady for a moment. Vashisthasana, left side. Let the right leg float up toward the sky. Sweep the right arm up overhead. Right leg forward, right arm back. And then switching directions, leg back, arm forward. You've got this. Right leg forward, right arm back. All the warmth you feel generating in your body is the fire that's going to digest all the bits and pieces. Good. Come on back through a high plank position, downward facing dog. One deep breath here, and on the exhale, open the mouth and have a gentle sigh. Ha. Soften the knees, walk the hands back. Uttanasana at the back of your mat. Inhale, lift halfway. Bend the left knee, touch the left hand on your next inhale, sweep the right arm to the sky. Exhale, touch down, switching sides. Right knee bends, left arm lifts. Exhale, touch down, relax the head. Soften the knees, inhale, roll to stand all the way up. Reach the fingertips high. Exhale, right arm back, left arm forward, look to the right thumb. Inhale, back to the top. Exhale, left arm back, right arm forward, look toward the left thumb. Beautiful. Inhale, back to the center. Palms find themselves over the head. Hopefully we can find ourselves too as we fold forward in gratitude and humility. Walk the hands forward, downward facing dog. Glide forward to a high plank position. One last time. Vashisthasana, right side. Lift the left leg, sweep the left arm overhead. Maybe matching the breath to the movement now. Left leg forward, left arm back, inhale. Switch directions, exhale. Switch directions, inhale. Switch directions, exhale. One more time. Switch directions, inhale. Good. Switch directions, exhale. High push-up position. Pause and gather your courage. Vashisthasana, left side. Lift the right leg up, sweep the right arm over. Right leg forward, right arm back. Inhale. Exhale, switch. Inhale, switch. Exhale, switch. Maybe noticing, inhale, that it's a little easier the second and third time. Exhale, switch. Beautiful high plank position. Just like a cow chewing its cud, lower your knees, untuck your toes, and lower the body down to the mat. Beautiful Sphinx pose. Knees, those are not knees, elbows under your shoulders. 10 fingers spread wide, toes reaching gently back behind you. Press gently down into the mat as you glide your heart forward and just close your eyes for a moment. Sometimes we expect ourselves to digest things the first time they come to us, but there's some wisdom in the way that cows digest their food. Let it come to you again and again. Seek it out again and again. And each time a deeper understanding will also come. Beautiful. Lower the chest, press into the hands, glide back to the hands and knees, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Big, deep inhale. Complete
soft, generous exhale.
Look between the hands, step the right foot there. Low lunge, lower your back knee, untuck the toes, press into the fingertips, draw the belly up and in. On your next inhale, sweep the arms forward and up. As the hips sink, extending the center of the chest gently up toward the sky. Good. Exhale, touch the hands around the front foot. Tuck your back toes, straighten your back leg. Simple twist, lifting the right arm high to the sky. Draw the right knee toward the midline as you spin your rib cage up toward the sky. Big, deep inhale. Exhale, touch the right hand outside the right foot, downward facing dog. Big, deep inhale. Generous exhale. Look between the hands, step the left foot there. Lower the back knee, untuck the toes, come to the fingertips and lift the chest. Draw the inner thighs gently together as you sweep the arms forward and up. Hips sinking toward the earth, chest lifting gently toward the sky. Inhale. Exhale, touch the hands down, tuck the back toes, straighten your right leg, and lift the left arm high to the sky, simple twist. Draw the left knee toward the midline, spin the chest open. Good. Touch the left hand down, downward facing dog. Inhale. Generous exhale. Look between the hands, move the feet forward, tiptoeing, hopping, jumping, cartwheeling, Uttanasana at the top of your mat. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, offer your heart forward. Exhale, fold deeply, relax the head and the neck. Inhale, all the way to stand, all the way up. Exhale the arms by the sides. Close your eyes. Inhale. Exhale. Soften your body. Soften your effort. Inhale. Exhale. Relax. Digest. Assimilate. One more big, deep inhale here. And as you exhale, imagine your feet just rooting and settling down into the ground. Beautiful. Inhale, sweep the arms forward and up. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, lift halfway, length through the spine. Exhale, big step back with that right leg. Lower the knee, keep the toes tucked, and gently lift the chest forward and up. Good. Inhale, sweep the arms up overhead. Back toes still tucked, maybe giving a greater, deeper sensation across the front of that right leg, stretching through the stomach meridian here. Good. Left elbow to the top of the left thigh, or maybe the left fingertips down to the ground as you reach the right arm up overhead. Making sure the breath is part of your dance here on your mat. Good. Inhale back to the top. Touch the fingertips behind the head, spread your elbows wide, and start to feel your head melting back into the palms of your hands. My favorite new little phrases here, just rest back into the wonder of it all. Good. Inhale back to a neutral spine. Exhale, start to dive your right elbow outside the outer edge of your left thigh. Forza and coraggio, feeling the stomach, the center of the body kind of compressing and twisting, helping to digest, making room for new, and straighten that back leg. As you straighten the back leg, see if you can lift the left elbow a little higher to the sky. Top of the head reaching gently forward. Everything strong, but breath is soft. Inhale, lift the whole shape up. And once again, just fall back into the wonder of it all. Beautiful. One more inhale here. Exhale, touch both hands around your front foot. Pause. Extend the left arm directly forward. Stay on the right palm or on the right fingertips. And on an inhale, straighten the left leg and reach the left hand high to the sky, a modified twisted triangle. Left fingertips reaching up toward the ceiling, left hip dropping toward the ground, right heel gently lifted, both legs steady and active. Beautiful. Look toward your left toes. Soften your left knee. Place both hands. Swing that left leg all the way back and up. Down dog splits. Bend your left knee. Open the left hip and have a deep breath as you feel maybe a freshness flowing through the abdomen, flowing through the center of the body. Good. Keep that left knee bent. Glide forward to a high push-up position and draw the left knee forward to find the left elbow. Look just in front of your fingertips. Feel the steadiness of your determination. And then step the left foot outside the left foot. Lower the back knee. Prishtasana, lizard pose. Untuck the back toes, press into your palms, lift the center of the chest and breathe. Stay here and enjoy, or reach that left arm high to the sky again, bend the right knee, and maybe find a connection of hand and foot behind you. If the hand and the foot don't come easily together, can you just digest that reality, that honesty? And try not to add too many thoughts to digest about it. Just find a place where you can enjoy and breathe. Digest what you can. Keep the body flowing. Beautiful. Release the hand and foot if they're together. Place the left hand back inside the left foot. Tuck the back toes. And a big step forward with the right foot outside the right hand. Inhale. Lengthen halfway. Hands are inside the feet. Feet are wide. Slightly different experience here. Exhale. Can you fold your elbows inside your knees, inside your legs? Knees can stay soft, head and neck relax. One more big deep breath here. And any residue, tension, stuff you don't need, let it come out your breath, let it tumble out the top of your head. Good. Walk the fingertips gently forward. Heel toe your feet back together at the top of your mat. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, big step back with that left foot, low lunge. Lower the back knee. Don't untuck the toes. Press into the fingertips and offer your heart forward. On your next inhale, arms sweep up overhead, letting the hips sink so the top half of the body is light. Right elbow to the top of the right thigh, maybe right fingertips to the mat beside your right hip. For everyone, the left arm reaching gently up and over. Breathe. Good. Inhale back to the top. Touch the fingertips behind your head. Let the head begin to rest back into the palms. Hips are sinking down, low belly gently drawing up and in, chest lifting. Really lean back into yourself. Good. Come on back to a neutral spine. And on an exhale, begin to dive the left elbow outside the outer edge of that right thigh. Draw the belly in once again. Get your breath and then begin to straighten that back leg. Left leg straight and strong. Right knee right over the right ankle and right elbow gently, tenderly lifting toward the sky. Take a big inhale into this twisted, compressed space and then lift the left elbow coming to a high lunge. Good. Inhale here, just a little lean back into yourself. And on an exhale, touch both hands around the front foot. Extend the right arm directly forward. And on your next inhale, straighten the right leg, circle the right arm up toward the sky, a modified twisted triangle. Left hand helping to keep you steady. Left heel lifting gently away from the mat, both legs extended and active. Right fingertips gently lifting as an encouragement for the rib cage to spin open. Right hip dropping down. Inhale, feel the top of the head lengthen toward the front of your mat. Exhale, look to the right toes, soften the right knee, touch the right hand down. Sweep that right leg all the way back and up behind you. Bend the knee and open the hip. Drink in a fresh breath of air. This moment, kind of like our lemon sorbet. And then keep that right knee bent as you glide forward. Draw the knee forward to find the outer edge of the right elbow. Pause. Look in front of the fingertips and step your right foot outside the right hand. Lower the back knee. Untuck the toes. Press into the palms and offer your heart forward. Breathe. Each exhale, an invitation to the body to assimilate, to process, to understand. Stay here or lift the right arm high to the sky. Bend the back knee, reach the hand toward the foot. Let the hips sink. Invite the chest to lift. Soften the wrinkles in your forehead and enjoy. Release the hand and the foot. Right hand places inside the right foot. Tuck the back toes and step forward with your left foot outside your left hand. Inhale, lift the chest forward and up. Do your best to keep your hands inside the legs. Exhale, bend the elbows between the legs as you drop the head and the neck to breathe. Inhale, feeling the spine like a waterfall cascading over the steadiness of your wide legs. Exhale. Release. Let it all pour out. Let the residue of your healthy digestion just pour through and out. Beautiful. Inhale, walk the fingertips forward, heel toe your feet back toward the center, Uttanasana. Inhale, once again, reaffirm the lengthening of the spine. Exhale, one more deep forward fold here. Good. Inhale, all the way to stand. all the way up, all the way up. Exhale the arms by the sides. Close your eyes. Inhale. Exhale. Soften your body. Inhale. Exhale. Relax. Digest. Assimilate. Inhale. A big drink of fresh breath in. Exhale. Feel your feet just falling into the ground beneath you, steady and certain. Let the eyes flutter open. Vrikshasana, tree pose. Bring the hands to the hips. Bend your left knee and externally rotate that left leg so the knee is facing out to the side. This kickstand posture, a perfect place to practice tree pose, or lift the foot to connect with the inner edge of the right calf, or reach down and assist the foot in coming all the way up and over the knee joint to somewhere on the inner thigh. Wherever that left foot lands, press the left foot into the inner edge of the right leg back in against the foot as if you're zipping up the center of your body. Keep the gaze, your eyes steady on one point, unmoving in front of you, and bring the palms together in prayer position. Here, digesting life in a slightly less stable place, what happens in the mind, what happens in the heart, can you witness, can you soften with an exhale and allow yourself to digest what is really there? Good. Draw that left knee forward in front of you. Warrior three. Keep the hands together in prayer position as you extend the left leg back out behind you, chest lowering until it's parallel to the ground, left leg reaching until it's parallel with the ground. Eyes stay at a point a few feet in front of your right toes. Find a new steadiness here, find a new softness here, and then as you're ready, reach the left fingertips down to the ground, and with a little more courage, begin to lift the right arm high to the sky, a twisted Ardha Chandrasana. Keep reaching that left leg strongly back behind you. Imagine zipping up a pair of pants that's a little too tight, and then spin the rib cage open any amount more. Relax your face. Good. Very softly, very gently, soften your right knee. Place your hands flat to your mat. Step all the way back toward a high lunge with your left foot. And then press into the palms and sweep that right leg all the way up and back once again, down dog splits. Bend the right knee, look under your left armpit and see if you can see your right toes. Maybe give them a little wiggle there. And then if you're feeling adventurous and if you've got room and if you feel safe, keep reaching those right toes toward the ground until maybe they land softly there. Wild thing, keep both knees soft. As you press into the left hand, press into both feet, lift the hips and begin to open the chest toward the sky. A big opening through that left shoulder, press down, keep those fingers active as you spin the center of your chest open toward the sky, maybe even looking back for the front of your mat. One more big deep inhale here. And as you exhale, place your right hand next to your left. Glide the right knee all the way forward for half pigeon pose. Right knee lands behind the right wrist. Right ankle behind the left wrist. Let the hips settle down, maybe keeping those back toes tucked. As you pay attention to internally rotating that back thighs, so the knee is facing down toward the mat. Feel free to relax those back toes anytime you wish, or if it feels good to keep that activation, keep it. Press onto the fingertips, lift the center of your chest like you're the front of a pirate ship. And then stay here and breathe into this conversation with the hip, or begin a journey forward, doing your best not to collapse forward, but to really be conscientious in your choices of folding forward to feel the sensations, to create a deeper flow through the hip. The first step forward is maybe to the elbows. The second step, perhaps just making a pillow with the backs of the hands and letting the forehead rest there. If you get to some place and you notice your breath has been left behind, just take a few steps backwards and recuperate it. If the breath isn't flowing, you're not digesting the information of the posture. So there isn't a big reason to be in that place. A nice time to look at our expectations. Maybe in any little judgments that creep in, and just know that you have to digest those too. So if you see them, take a nice big inhale. And as you exhale, just like a gentle breeze clearing your workspace, just blow that dust away, let it keep flowing, and return to your honesty and digest what you can. If your body has folded close to the floor, start to walk your way back up to a more vertical position and pause there for a moment to lift the chest. Please tuck your back toes and see if you can lengthen that back knee up away from your mat any amount. Beautiful. Plant your palms, tuck your back toes, downward facing dog. Inhale here, and as you exhale, just let your tail wag a little bit here in your down dog. Great, and then look between the hands, another nice deep breath in, and on your exhale, move the feet forward in any way that feels good. Inhale, offer your heart forward, length from the tailbone to the top of the head, exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way to stand, all the way up. And as you exhale, see if you can immediately just relax. We'll try the other side. Bring your hands to your hips, bend your right knee, coming up to the ball of the right foot, and then externally rotate that knee to the side. Staying here in kickstand pose, or letting the right foot glide to the inner edge of the right calf, or lifting it, maybe with the assistance of your hand, up and over the knee joint to find the left inner thigh. Right foot presses into the left inner thigh. Left inner thigh presses back in to the right foot. Palms together in prayer position. Eyes steady. Just digesting all the little shakes and wiggles that create the dance of stability by keeping the body soft with generous exhales. Good. Draw that right knee toward the center, releasing the foot. Warrior three, glide the right leg back behind you. Palms stay in prayer position. Belly comes parallel to the floor, right leg also reaching parallel to the floor. Maybe spread through those left toes just a little bit more, finding some deeper rooting down into that base leg. One honest, soft breath with a relaxed face if you can. And then touch those right fingertips down to the ground. Find your steadiness here. And then maybe reaching that left arm high to the sky, a twisted Ardha Chandrasana, strong right leg behind you. Belly drawing gently up and in, rib cage twisting open, open, open. Good. Touch the left hand down. Soften the left knee. Reach the right leg all the way back to a high lunge. Reaffirm the position of the hands and sweep that left leg all the way up and back. Down dog splits. Bend the left knee. Look under your right armpit and wiggle those left toes and see if you can find them with your eyes. And then keep reaching those left toes toward the ground. Both knees are soft as you land gently toward Wild Thing, lifting the hips, letting the chest open toward the sky, taking a break, gracefully finding your way to the ground if that's the right way to digest this information, and maybe looking back for the front of the mat as the chest lifts and the hips lift. Pigeon pose left side, gracefully land the left hand to the mat. As gracefully as you can, glide that left knee forward to fall behind the left wrist, left ankle behind the right wrist, hips begin to sink, back toes staying tucked maybe for a moment longer, just to see if you can spin that right inner thigh up and in to help the right knee face down toward the mat. And then coming toward the fingertips, propping yourself up a little bit here to lift through the chest. Staying here or beginning your journey forward, one choice at a time, one piece of information to digest at a time. Pausing on the elbows, even if you know you're going to try to go deeper. And then choosing a place to be anywhere along the way where the breath is steady and natural. The hips in traditional Chinese medicine, we like to call them like the life saddlebags, where we often tuck into our pockets residue of stuff that we haven't digested well or completely. So these hip openers, such a beautiful opportunity to help fulfill those processes to create a deeper flow in the places that tend to get easily stuck, so that the next pieces of information that come in to be digested have a clearer place to arrive. A few more deep breaths here. Using the body as a metaphor for our life, it's not always so important to identify what it is. Letting the sensations come and go and being a non-judging witness. Begin to walk the hands back to bring yourself to a more upright position. Come on up to the fingertips here. Tuck the back toes if they're not already and see if you can lengthen that right knee away from your mat any amount as you lift through the chest. Beautiful. Good. Plant the palms, tuck your back toes. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog.
And just wag your tail here again, once again. A little wiggle and shake. Beautiful. Come on back to the center. Gracefully lower your knees down to the mat. Puppy dog pose. Keep your hips steady over your knees and begin to walk your hands forward. Hips stay really high here as the heart and the chest melt toward the ground, arms reaching forward, 10 fingers spreading wide. You can imagine a gentle stretching of the organs here, a gentle stretching of the stomach. Literally creating space for better, healthier digestion. And in that, maybe creating space for better choices about what we choose to bring into our environment, into our bodies. And that's a choice too. And then as gracefully as you can, not always the most graceful exit, begin to walk back to your hands and your knees. Sit the hips back toward the heels in a kneeling position, and then shift your hips to one side or the other to extend the legs out in front of you. Dandasana, staff pose. Flex your toes toward your nose, activating through the legs. Press the palms next to your hips. And if you have penguin arms like me, a little shorter maybe than the length of the spine, maybe up on the fingertips a bit. Relax the shoulders away from the ears and just sit up really nice and tall. And then drop the chin gently toward the chest as the chest lifts gently toward the chin. Maybe close the eyes here for the next breath or two. Feel the legs active and steady. Feel the spine long. On your next inhale, lift the chin away from the chest. I'm just spinning to reorient myself a little bit from your straight legs. Just bend them so the feet are flat to the floor. Inchworm your bum a little closer to your heels. Reach the fingertips forward and one vertebrae at a time. Come on down to the mat. Once you're down, reach the arms up overhead. Stretch the legs out beneath you and have a big, long, delicious stretch. Good. As you're ready, draw the right knee into the chest and give it a little hug. Pavanamuktasana. Draw that right thigh up and gently around the right side of the abdomen, stimulating the ascending colon. Our ability to take in. And then moving here to a gentle twist, left hand guides the right knee across the left side of the body, right arm extending at shoulder height. As you exhale, imagine your body softening. Imagine your ability not to hold things that don't belong to you. Imagine cleansing and clearing the residue of anything that you have yet to digest fully. Beautiful. Come on back to the center. Hug that right knee back into the chest. Bend the left knee, left foot flat to the floor. Cross the right ankle over the top of the left knee, figure four position. Stay here Or thread the right arm through the legs, left arm around the outside of the left thigh, hands finding a grasp behind the left thigh. Right toes a little bit active toward the sky, and maybe a few rocks right and left here, just to find a sweet sensation on the outer edge of that right hip. If you want to find a different conversation, walk those hands up to the top of the left shin, keeping the shoulders, the neck, and the face really super relaxed here. And then just for fun, give this a try. Tense everything. And see what you feel. See what comes to you. And then from there, relax once again with a really deep exhale. And just notice the difference of how that feels, what information is available. And as a last offering here, hands back to the back of the left thigh, lengthening the left leg, flexing the left toes toward your nose. And maybe beginning to walk those hands up the back of the left leg, bringing the left toes up and overhead any amount, but again, keeping the shoulders, the neck, the face really nice and relaxed. One more deep breath here. Good. Gently release the left leg, thigh. Bend the left leg. Place the left foot to the floor. Uncross your right ankle and separate your feet to the edges of the mat. Reach your arms up overhead and just windshield wiper through the knees, right and left, right and left, right and left. Again, all these sweet, simple movements don't necessarily need a deeper meaning as we're moving through, but creating a deeper integration in the flow and functionality of the parts of the body responsible for digestion. It can start that simple. Come on back to the center. Stretch those legs out down beneath you and have another sweet stretch of the whole body. And then as you're ready, grab a hold of that left knee and draw it up and in toward the chest. Hug the left thigh around the outer edge of the left abdomen, the left rib cage, stimulating the descending colon. Even the process of digestion, reflecting the idea of yoga. The in must also have an out. The descending colon, our ability to healthfully let go of the byproducts of digestion. Great. Bend the right knee, place the right foot flat to the floor. Cross your left ankle over the top of the right knee and maybe just staying here or threading the arms and grabbing a hold of the back of that right thigh. Shoulders and throat relaxed, breath easy and flowing. And if you tried on the first side, maybe walking those hands to the right shin just below the knee and using the gentle strength of the biceps to pull the legs a little closer to the chest. We won't try tensing the body on this side because I don't know about you, but it doesn't feel that good to me. But that's what the body feels like when we try to digest too many things without giving ourselves space to fulfill the process of digestion. And then maybe taking a hold of the back of that right thigh, sending the right toes high to the sky, straightening through the right leg, flexing the right toes toward the face,
And then a gentle pulling of that straight leg in toward the chest, or maybe a releasing of the hands walking up the back of that right leg and folding in across the low belly any amount. And wherever you choose to be, whatever situation, you create a few honest breaths to allow the body to digest the suggestion. Beautiful. Release the right leg, soften it, foot to the floor, uncross your left ankle, separate the feet the width of the mat, reach the arms up overhead and windshield wiper through those knees. Right and left, right and left, right and left. Right, and then come on back to the center, a gentle hugging of both knees into the chest. You can draw the forehead up toward the knees if that feels good. Maybe even a little rock right and left here. Right and left. Good. And then let the feet fall to the floor. Reach the arms up overhead once again, and a gentle roll onto one side of the body or the other. Kind of like you're coming out of Shavasana here. Let the head rest on the bottom arm and have a deep breath. And then gently, but in an integrated way, come on back up to a seated position and find a kneeling position. Heels under the hips and knees close together. Closing our practice today together with a gentle mudra for digestion, mudra, an attitude, a gesture that energetically helps the body in a direction. Make a fist with your hands and gently place the finger side of your fist just below your belly button. If you extend your thumbs up, they should make a little triangle toward the belly button. If the tips of the thumbs rest on the belly button, that's where about your palms, your fists should rest. And then close those thumbs back into your fists again. Inhale gently here. And as you exhale, fold the whole body over the pressure of those fists and see if you can't rest the forehead to the floor in front of you. If the forehead is far from the floor and you happen to have a pillow or a book or a can of soup close by, the can of soup might not be the most comfortable option. You can rest your forehead on some item that brings the floor closer to you. And as you start to settle into this place, our final gesture, our final offering in this particular ritual for our day. It might not feel the most comfortable, but see, just like all the other suggestions you've given your body throughout the practice, you can offer a few generous exhales to invite that gentle pressure of your fists into your guts, into your belly. No need to press, no need to seek, no need to dig. This gentle binding of the flow of energy through the low belly. A deep refreshment for our ability to digest all of life. If emotions begin to flow through, or the breath wants to stop, just notice, let them keep flowing by inviting your breath to be a steady presence
by offering continuously some generous exhales. And with this presence, see if for the next three deep breaths you can feel your belly filling and pressing up around against the fists, the thighs. As always, if this feels like a really useful investigation, please feel free to stay a few moments longer. This position, something that can be incorporated into your daily ritual, 10 minutes of moving and breathing. 10 minutes of honoring that we have to digest everything that comes our way. Moving and breathing gives us the gift of the best possible template upon which to do that. When you're ready, very gently begin to lift away from the thighs. And just coming back to a kneeling position, extending the fingers and letting them rest on the tops of the thighs. You can keep your eyes closed here if they were closed for a few moments more, but feel the circulation returning to the belly, to the fingers, maybe even to the arms, the forehead. And then join the palms together in front of the heart center. This beautiful gesture of yoga, unification of things that often seem like opposites in life, but actually together create the dance of life. There's a lot to digest. Move and breathe and give yourself the opportunity to keep that process healthful. Just be aware gently of the choices you make throughout the day, environment, nourishment, people, information. And see if you can't interject just a few moments here and there to put it all down, to turn your face to the sun, and to allow yourself to fully digest all that you're taking in. Namaste.